So we've reached the end of Cat Royale. For 12 days, our three superstar cats have visited a little utopia and played with a robot. Today, we had the highest rated game of all. For 7 minutes, Ghostbuster, Pumpkin, and Clover took turns in playing with the feather helicopter. Had the AI worked its algorithmic magic to give them just the right thing at just the right time? Or was it the cats who led? Maybe they found a way to make their own fun together. As we look back over the 500 games that the AI offered to the cats, we've seen games which failed to grab their attention, and we've seen the AI learn to focus on games that the cats loved. The cats have had no problem with the robot and were relaxed around it from the start. In fact, Clover and Ghostbuster queued up outside the room each morning, waiting to be let in. So what have we learned? Firstly, AI is a profoundly human process that's laborious and expensive. We tag 7,500 video clips to train the computer vision system. A robot operator controlled every move of the robot arm. The system may be automated, but the automation is always being tweaked and monitored. Secondly, AI design must be multidisciplinary. We need many voices in the room as we design solutions. On Cat Royale, we have had vets and computer scientists, experts in feline behaviour and roboticists, artists and computer vision specialists. And we've had an audience advisory panel of 15 members of the public from diverse backgrounds to guide us as we've developed this work. For the artist's perspective, here's Matt.
As the cats spent their last afternoon in the room, the whole team slowly gathered around the two-way mirrors to watch. I felt suddenly sad seeing Clover play with the robot for the last time. We've tried to measure her happiness, but maybe what Clover wants is not what she needs. Hopefully, we've given her and Ghostbuster and Pumpkin a life-enriching experience, but we'll never know that. The cats in Cat Royale are, of course, us. We are experimenting with a culture that privileges choice and consumer power above all else. What does it mean when our every whim can be met by automated systems? When our desires can be met so quickly, the satisfaction that we seek becomes more fleeting and insubstantial as a result. And now that the most powerful companies on earth can quickly roll out their products to billions of people with the goal of instant gratification, what costs might we pay for AI?
Thanks for watching the highlights of Cat Royale. If you want to follow the future of the project, head over to our website at blasttheory.co.uk/Cat Royale. And if you want a little fix of Clover, Pumpkin, and Ghost, why not watch again from day one?